Hello everyone. Today, in this video, let's talk about the charting and recording time series data from the remote Modbus device. Charting data is a very useful feature when you want to visually track Modbus data that is too fast to track visually. In this video, I want to show how to use this feature from Modbus Monitor XPF tool. Be sure you have it updated to at least version 3 to use this feature. Alright, let's get started. We will be using Modbus Monitor XPF in server mode to simulate remote Modbus TCP server or PLC device. Another instance of the application will be used in the client mode to pull the server, chart the data graphically. We will show all steps to capture the data in time series plot. Let's start the demo. I have Modbus Monitor XPF running in server mode. I have another copy of the Modbus Monitor XPF running as the client. Again, this is the client mode used for charting, while server mode is used to simulate remote Modbus TCP device with fast-moving data in holding register. Let's start fresh and delete all existing monitor points. Now add fresh new monitor point with first holding register as data type as integer 16. Next, click on extension button to expose additional options. Select simulate and choose sine wave to generate slow 100 mHz sine wave with Nyquist sampling rate of 100 milliseconds or 50 milliseconds update at twice per sample rate. Oh, let's set gain of 100 as the peak amplitude of the generated sine wave. Again, let's start fresh and delete all monitor points. Add first holding register and verify the data point is set up as integer. Click on extension button to show more options. Enable chart option and select Y to show data. You have two axes to choose. Choose either 0 or 1. Other values are ignored. Click on the chart button to show chart. Let's start the sever to simulate the sine wave waveform generator on first holding register at 50 milliseconds rate. Choose client tab and select TCP. Start the Modbus TCP client. Click on chart button to see the live time series data time stamped in the UTC format. Notice how the chart waveform is irregular and does not truly represent the fast data generated at 50 milliseconds rate. This is due to slow capture rate. Let's increase the capture or sample rate that matches closely with the server. To fix this, let's change poll data interframe and interval to 0 to capture data fast as possible. Now, the waveform now truly represents the actual data generated by the simulator. Be sure to adjust as needed for your application. Now let's discuss some controls related to chart. Click on Chart Options tab in the header. Click on Start to pause the chart. The sample value controls how many points are shown in the graph. Fit button scales chart to fit the display window. Save button records sample data in a CSV format to a file stored in My Documents folder. Here is an example data recorded in the file. We will draw chart in the Excel and verify that data looks good. Alright, we have reached the end of the video. In this view, we showed how to simulate and chart dynamic data. Hope this feature helps you track and save fast data for forensic analysis. You can download the trial version of the application either by contacting us or from Windows Store. Check out my other videos on installing using the Modbus Monitor XPF application. If you want to see more videos like these in the future, please consider subscribing. Alright, this is all I have you for today.